Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to Raymond Limited Q1 FY22 results conference call hosted by Antique Stock Broking. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Abhijeet Kundu of Antique Stock Broking. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Yeah, thanks. On behalf of Antique Stock Broking, I would like to welcome all the participants in the earnings call of Raymond Limited. I have with me Mr. Jay Mukund, who is the Head of Investor Relations of Raymond Limited. Without taking further time, I would like to hand over the call to Mr. Mukund. Over to Mukund.
Thank you, Abhijeet. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us for our Q1 FY22 earnings conference call of Raymond Limited. I hope all of you would have received a copy of our results presentation. I would like to urge you to go through this along with the disclaimer slides. Today, we have with us Mr. S.L. Pokarna, Director, Raymond Limited, Mr. Amit Agarwal, Group CFO, Mr. Ganesh Kumar, Chief Operating Officer, Lifestyle Business, and Mr. Harmohan Sahni, who has recently joined in June 2021 as CEO of our Realty business. I will now hand over call to our Group CFO, Amit Agarwal, who will give you the summary of our company's quarterly performance before we open up the floor for our Q&A session. Over to you, Amit.
Thank you, Mukund. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. These are testing times, and I hope you and your near and dear ones are safe. Thank you for joining us today on this earnings call to discuss our results of first quarter of fiscal 2022. Let me give you an overview of the market. The market witnessed a bullish start at the beginning of the calendar year 2021, that is January to March quarter, with improvement in consumer sentiments, opening up of the economy, and recovering of sales. The momentum was expected to continue in the first quarter of the current financial year, that is the April to June quarter, on the back of strong wedding season and positive consumer sentiments. However, from beginning of April 2021, wave of COVID-19, which is considered to be more severe compared to first wave, which occurred in last year, resulted into local lockdowns across the country, starting from west, followed by north, east, and southern regions. Throughout the quarter, varying degrees of regional lockdowns were implemented by local authorities. There were restricted hours of store operations on weekdays, complete shutdown on weekends, market opening on alternate days, and essential to non-essential categorization, which largely affected the consumer footfalls in retail network at impacting sales. At the trade level, primary sales dipped during the quarter as channel partners became cautious as unsold inventory was lying all across supply chain. At retail level, especially the retail outlets and large format stores were impacted due to mall closures, resulting into delay in end of season sale as well. From online channel perspective, sales of non-essential items also slowed down as some of the key states put restrictions on e-com deliveries. However, from later half of the June month, with phase-wise unlocking and partial ease of restrictions, some recovery in consumer sentiment was witnessed. Also, the secondary sales improved with ease of mobility, mainly contributed by recovery in lower tier markets compared to metros and tier 1 and 2 cities. Now let me give you some key financial highlights for the quarter fiscal 2021 first quarter. Second wave of pandemic resulted in stricter lockdowns across India, impacting sales recovery during the quarter. As the unlock began, we witnessed slightly better sales in the later part of the June month. Our consolidated revenue stood at 862 crore, up 289% as compared to 222 crore in fiscal quarter FY 2021. Our continued focused approach on optimizing operating expenses during the quarter continued. While the revenue increased by 3x, the operating expense increased by 26% over the previous year from 275 crore in first quarter fiscal 21 to 347 crore in fiscal quarter FY22. Our reported EBITDA was 7 crores for the quarter as compared to an EBITDA loss of 167 crores in first quarter fiscal 21, resulting in improvement of 175 crore in this quarter. The net loss before exceptions for the quarter was 114 crore as compared to 242 crore in the previous year. During the quarter, the company had considered an exceptional loss of 43 crore, which includes the following: gain on recognition of fair value of development rights received as non-monetary compensation in lieu of acquisition of land by Thane Municipal Corporation, Thane, amounting to 92 crores. We also received an interim insurance claim on account of fire occurred at one of the company's premises at Thane, amounting to 10 crores. In the apparel business, the company also made a provision for discount sharing with customers on trade receivables of 117 crore and certain inventory write-down of 29 crore due to second wave of the pandemic. We will discuss this in more detail in our branded apparel segment. Net loss after the above mentioned exceptional items for the quarter was 157 crore as compared to 242 crore in last year. Now let me talk about the operational performance in more detail. If you look at the revenue, the first quarter fiscal 22 revenues were severely impacted by the local lockdowns across the country due to second wave of the pandemic. All the B2B businesses performance were well and contributed to almost 40% of the total revenues. In our co-branded textile segment, there was a dip in price as trade channel and market remained muted. This was due to lower secondary sales as the retail network was either shut or operated with restricted timings due to regional lockdowns. However, with phase-wise opening of states along with continued restrictions, the market witnessed some recovery in late part of the June month. In our B2B segments, the quarter witnessed continued momentum in both of our engineering business as well as auto business. Export markets remained buoyant with strong demand in global markets. Despite strong order book, lockdown-induced operational disruptions and port congestion resulted delay in dispatches. In case of garmenting business, while we have a robust order book, stringent lockdown restriction in Karnataka impacted the dispatches. In our real estate business, while the sale of the new units were affected as major part of the quarter was impacted due to local lockdowns, however, fast-paced construction activity during the quarter in all the 10 towers of the project resulted in higher revenues and milestone completions during the quarter. Let me talk about the EBITDA and the operating cost. We reported an EBITDA of 7 crores for the quarter as compared to an EBITDA loss of 167 crore in first quarter fiscal 21. There was a continued profitable performance by both the engineering business, B2B shirting and real estate business. On the operating cost front, their continued focused approach on optimizing operating expenses resulted in controlling the cost during the quarter. The overall increase of 72 crores to 347 crores as compared to 275 crores in first quarter of fiscal 21 is primarily due to increased level of operations. The OPEX cost has increased by 72 crores over first quarter of fiscal 21 to 347 crore in first quarter of fiscal 22, while revenue has increased by 289% during the same period. We began our cost rationalization exercise in first quarter of fiscal 21 immediately after the lockdown. For ease of reference, in the last financial year of fiscal 21, we were able to achieve cost reduction to the tune of 40% as compared to fiscal 20. If we talk about the OPEX cost in the first quarter of fiscal 20 was 531 crore, which reflects a reduction of 184 crore in first quarter of fiscal 22. Now, let me explain the key operating costs in detail. Our employee cost increased from 171 crore in first quarter of fiscal 21 to 194 crore in first quarter of fiscal 22 due to normalization of employee benefit expenses. Also, as already stated, our store rationalization is in progress to make our retail portfolio healthy. Net store closure is 27 for the first quarter of fiscal 22, taking the retail network to 1,459 stores as on 30th of June 2021. Let me talk about the working capital. We continue to stay focused on efficient working capital management. Despite lockdown and lower secondary sales, with continued efforts across all businesses, our collections have been very encouraging and we could maintain the receivable levels similar to March 21 levels. During the quarter, though the plants operated at lower levels, however, due to severity of the lockdown, the sales and dispatches were significantly impacted and thereby the inventory levels increased, resulted in overall increase in net working capital by 92 crores from 1117 crores as on 31st March 2021 to 1209 crore as on 30th of June 2021. Due to above reasons, the operating cash flow was negative at 108 crore and free cash flow was negative to the tune of 196 crore for the first quarter fiscal 22. Our net debt increased by approximately 200 crore from 1,416 crore as on 31st of March 2021 to 1,617 crore as on 30th June 2021. The average interest rate level was maintained at the March 21 levels at 8.34%. The company believes that during these pandemic times, it is prudent to ensure and maintain healthy, adequate liquidity levels of around 600 to 650 crores. And as on 30th of June, our liquidity level stood at 645 crores, which includes cash and cash equivalents. Now, let me talk about our various segments in detail. In our branded textile segment, the sales grew to 283 crores compared to 17 crore in the previous year for the same quarter. The recovery was hampered due to second lockdown across the country, impacting the primary and secondary sales. However, the segment witnessed recovery in the month of June as primary sales picked up with partial unlocking of states in a phased manner in later part of the June month. Suitings business grew by higher volumes in wholesale and trade channels and increased offtake of premium gifting solutions, which were introduced at attractive price points. When the second wave of pandemic triggered similar lockdowns like last year, we had our learning and were not caught unaware. The business was equipped with spruced up supply chain and smarter inventory management. Our mark-to-market execution was agile as we were able to translate customer requirements into physical sales through prompt dispatches of our products. Our preparedness was a catalyst to service our customers, which resulted in high volumes of sales during the quarter that was mired by lockdown across the country. Let me talk about our branded apparel segment, where the sales stood at 75 crore in the quarter, impacted primarily due to continued lockdown for both our trade and retail channels. Our EBOs and LFS channels continued to be impacted as most of the malls across the country remained shut during the quarter. This segment reported an EBITDA loss of 29 crore. Now, let me explain to you about the exceptional item relating to apparel business. As we all are aware that the apparel fashion industry works on the freshness of inventory, due to the lockdown, the stores were shut. The sales dropped drastically, resulted into an inventory built up at the trade channel level reflecting slow collections. Due to resurgence of COVID second wave, which impacted the summer 21 sales, our channel partners have not been able to sell in two consecutive summer seasons, that is summer 20 as well as summer 21, and the same have resulted an increase in inventory in the supply chain. With the objective of faster realization of trade receivables and providing fresh inventory to customers, the company decided to offer certain discounts to liquidate inventories held by channel and other inventories. Accordingly, a provision has been made to the tune of 117 crore on account of discount sharing and 29 crore towards write down of certain inventory. Let me talk about the most strong point for Raymond, which is the retail network. As of June 2021, we had 1,459 stores spread across 600 towns. All the operational stores are complying with stringent safety guidelines, including contactless payments. Since the majority of our retail outlets are spread across high streets, customer needs were addressed even when the malls were closed. As already explained, we are strongly focused on making our EBO portfolio healthy, and during the quarter, we closed 35 stores. At the same time, we are continuously evaluating opportunities which strengthen our retail footprint. During the quarter, we opened 8 stores, mainly in Tier 2, 3, 4 category towns. Considering our garmenting segment, which caters to the export market, the sales stood at 98 crore as compared to 100 crore in previous year. The revenue practically remained flat. Though the order book continues to be very strong, the dispatches could not be made due to stringent lockdowns in Karnataka, resulting in stoppages in plant production. The EBITDA margin for the quarter was 0.9%. If we talk about high-value cotton shirting, which is primarily catering to the B2B segment, the sales stood at 101 crore as compared to 6 crore in the previous year. Revenue recovery, led by higher number of orders from our B2B customers, helped the EBITDA margin to achieve at 6.2%. Tools and hardware segment, the sales continued to be strong at 110 crore as compared to 20 crore in previous year. Sales were driven mainly by exports in our key markets of LATAM, Africa, and Asia. EBITDA margin for the quarter was at 11.3%. Let me talk about the auto component sales, where the sales stood at 70 crore as compared to 21 crore in previous year. The sales were also driven in this segment because of the export market and well supported by recovery in auto sector in the domestic market. The EBITDA margin for the quarter was at 15.9%. Let me talk about our newest business, which is the real estate business. The sale of new units were affected as major part of the quarter was impacted due to local lockdown as the experience center was closed, impacted bookings. However, constant active engagement with customers during lockdown through digital medium coupled with sustained lower home loan interest rate triggered conversions of inquiries into bookings, especially in the month of June. Overall, we received 61 bookings in the first quarter of fiscal 22, resulting in a total of 1,448 units booked so far, that is approximately 60% of the total inventory launched till June 2021 with a booking value of close to 1,400 crore. The business continued fast-paced construction activity during the quarter in all 10 towers of the project. Let me give you tower-wise construction status. For the first tower 1, 2, and 3, we have completed the 40th floor slab. For the tower 4, 27th floor work is in progress. Tower 5, 6, and 7, first floor slab is in progress. Tower 8, plinth work is in progress. And Tower 9 and 10 is the foundation work is in progress. So this clearly reflects that our real estate team and the people were deployed there in order to move the progress faster on the project. Let me update you about the demerger, which is an important step for the group. We expect the overall process to be completed in the current financial year, that is fiscal 22. As and when we have a meaningful update, we will inform each one of you accordingly. Let me see how the status of the operation is as we see today and a near-term outlook in an environment which is very uncertain considering the possibility of the third wave and so on and so forth. We are witnessing recovery in the primary sales due to phase-wise unlocking of the state with ease of lockdown, restrictions, and improving status of vaccination. However, concerns of the third COVID wave making trade channel cautious in buying significantly large quantities. Higher presence of TRS in high street and lower tiers aided moderate recovery despite majority of the retail network continue to operate with limited store timings on weekdays and weekend closures, impacting footfalls, leading to overall slower recovery in sales. Recovery in LFS is low due to continued closure of malls. Export markets are witnessing recovery in B2B businesses of garmenting and engineering businesses of both tools and hardware and auto components with very healthy order books as global economies are opening up with steady growth in demand. Construction activity in our real estate business is in full swing and we are complying with all the relevant guidelines. As far as liquidity is concerned, our continued focus on liquidity management continues through the cost reduction initiatives and net working capital optimization and followed by strong vigil on the CapEx. Thank you very much. Now we will be taking the questions. Operator.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Dixit Doshi from Whitestone Financial Advisors. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good evening, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. My question is, last year in FY22, we had done around 1600 crore top line in branded apparel division. So my question is, do we manufacture entire raw material used in this apparel division? Because we also have purchase of stock in trade worth 1250 crores. So we get this apparel manufactured outside the textile that is used for this apparel division is entirely in-house manufactured and supplied, or we have to purchase from outside? This is my first question. Historically, the EBITDA margins in apparel division has been very low. So what is the sustainable kind of EBITDA margins in apparel business once things normalize? What are the plans for the future monetization of the remaining land parcel in Thane? Are we going to develop it entirely ourselves, or we also have plans to sell or enter into a JV with someone? So, and my last question is, sir, what is the construction cost per square feet in the towers that we are making right now? What is the construction cost per square feet, and what kind of realization per square feet we are getting here? These are my few questions. I'll again get back in the line, sir.
Sure. No, I appreciate it. So let me talk in the sequence the way you have said. And my colleagues are, I'll request them to add where necessary. So if I look at it in terms of the branded apparel, clearly, you see, our focus is that we produce very high quality fabrics and our fabrics get used in the making of the apparel. However, all the apparels which we sell under our branded name gets manufactured by third party, except for some quantities where we have the facilities in Bangalore for our garmenting units. There we manufacture some of the products which we sell. So thereby we see very clear that you have the right structure by which you use the MSMEs to manufacture the, do the contract manufacturing of the apparel which is getting sold under our branded name. So that's number one. Second thing, in terms of the EBITDA margin, you know, EBITDA margins, what happens is in a sustainable basis, I think the most important part you have to see is that what we had the cost structure in FY20, FY19, we have pruned down the cost structure in a dramatic manner, and we have brought almost 50% reduction in that cost structure. And that will enable us, and certain channels which we have taken will help us to improve the margins. So there is a very clear path the company has in terms of improving the margin. However, I would not like to spell out a number, but we will see progressively over the quarters how the improvement in the EBITDA margins are happening. In terms of monetization of Thane land, look, you know it very well that in 2018, we sold 20-acre parcel land for a 700 crore, which translates into almost 35 crore an acre. So we have also demonstrated that we will sell the land. Similarly, when we are doing the construction on our parcel of a 16-acre parcel, we are constructing 3.2 million. So it will be a mixed bag. We will see the opportunities. You know very well that during the COVID times, it is inappropriate. We will not get the right offer. So therefore, it is not something that we will not look into it. We will take the opportunity to sell the Thane land as well as we continue to see the construction. And maybe it is today we are doing into the residential. Maybe we have an opportunity to do commercial, do some other type of usage. Mixed usage is possible. So that's the way. As far as construction cost and is concerned, see, we are, the beauty of Raymond Realty is have progressed and worked so efficiently that they are in a position to complete within 7 days, they can cast one slab. So that reflects about the efficiency of the company and the work by which we do. As far as the realization is concerned, you know very well in a real estate market, the location and the timeliness of completion of the project. So we are significantly ahead in terms of completion of the project. You see the first three towers, we are supposed to deliver, let's say, still 3 years to go, but we believe that we will have a possibility to deliver sooner than later. So therefore, we see that our ability to construct faster at an economical cost and giving the right quality of amenities is critical, because this is a showcase project for us also, that we are giving the best quality amenities so that we make a clear understanding to the customers that we provide a great life when people buy the homes at Raymond Realty.
Yeah, I appreciate your answer, sir, but I was looking at a number for the construction cost per square foot and the realization per square foot.
Yeah, so that, as I said, keep, look, these are some of the things which we are not disclosing, because the realization, you can know very well what is the Thane market. Every project has their own certain premium. And as far as construction cost is concerned, we are quite competitive. And that is reflected over the next 4 years. And we have already given a guidance that our this project, this 16-acre aspirational project, will deliver what kind of free cash flow from the project. It is in excess.
Yeah. And my last question is, out of this net debt of 1600 crore, so post-merger, how much of this debt will go to the, you know, the new entity, and how much of it will remain in this listed entity?
So look, this is that today the treasury is common. We work through a common treasury. But at the time of demerger, we will be able to see that how much debt goes into the lifestyle entity and how much goes to the non-lifestyle entity. So that is something
we don't have a clarity of the number right now.
So as I said, when the demerger happens, then we will take the debt into the lifestyle, whatever is the debt relating to lifestyle business. Because basically it is a working capital debt which is relating to the lifestyle business. And okay, other businesses, practically we have no debt in our
so
tools.
Large part of the debt will go to the lifestyle business. Am
yes,
I right?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. And Pukharna ji, if you want to add something on the apparel, the way to do the businesses.
You have answered everything, Amit ji. Thank you for that. But I think that one in question, there was one more part that all garments manufactured are being sourced from our in-house. My answer to this is yes, whatever is being produced is being taken from our in-house facilities. But however, there are many special kind of fabrics like knits and like silk or so many other kind of fabrics are there. Those are being outsourced. Also, conversion of these garments happens into our factories, but at the same time, we have facilities which we need higher capacity, and we go outside conversion also. So that is one. And second is, I would like to add, the demand is recovering in the marketplace, and we are seeing good footfalls into our channels. So we expect we are expecting good results in moving forward.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Before we take the next question, I'd like to remind our participants to limit their question to two per participant. If time permits, you may join the queue for any follow-up. The next question is from the line of Meet Jain from LKP Securities. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, thank you, sir, for giving the opportunity. My first question is on the online sales part. So in this quarter, what would the percentage of our online or e-commerce sales of our total revenue? Hello. Hello.
Yes. So it seems we have lost line for Amit Agarwal, sir. We are reconnecting him.
Okay.
Yes, Amit, sir. Please go ahead.
Yeah.
And Meet, please repeat the question. Thank you.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah.
Yeah. So my question was on the online sales or e-commerce business. I mean, what percentage of our revenue came from this online channel? Hello.
Hello. Can you please reconnect again, Amit?
Yeah, we have just lost the line for him. We'll reconnect him. Participants request you to stay connected. Thank you. Gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for patiently waiting. We have the line for Mr. Amit Agarwal connected. Sir, over to you. And Meet,
yeah.
Sorry, please go ahead with the question, Meet.
I'm extremely sorry for this disruption in the line. So sorry for this.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you very well.
Yeah, sure. So, my first question is, are our online sales, what percentage of our revenue came from our online sales or e-commerce business?
Okay. So, if you see, in our business, what happens is, fabric does not sell online. It is only the apparel segment which sells online. So, what we have been able to do, and especially in this quarter, the challenge was that many states did not enable the online sales, the e-commerce deliveries for the non-essential products. So therefore, the sales were impacted. However, as I earlier explained, that on a normalized business, from the apparel side, we do around the 22 to 24% as an online sales on a normalized basis. So that is the share which we have been able to do. However, what we are today more encouraged to look at is the omni-channel sales, because we believe that the omni-channel sales is a very, very important factor which translates into a physical experience. When you talk about a physical experience, that means you can buy online, go to the nearest store, the Raymond shop or an EBO, and there you have the flexibility to change your clothes, you can do a return, you can get a new product, you can also do various kind of things, alterations. So what we have been able to focus is that we move into the online channel, omni-channel presence, so that because we are present in more than 600 cities, so we have that unique advantage that even if you buy an online, we can service you online as well as the ability for you to have a conversation with the store and get minor alterations, returns, changes, or different designs. That is all feasible.
So, got it. So, 22 to 24% is on a normalized basis. Like, okay.
for the fabric side of the story. Sorry, for the apparel.
Apparel business. Right.
Yeah.
And next question is on our fashion collection season. Like earlier, we used to do around two seasons annually, and in previous calls, we were discussing that it will be increased to around 4 or 6 fashion collection seasons. So have you started implementing that?
Yeah. So I'll ask Ganesh Kumar to respond on the fabric side, and Mr. Okarna will respond on the apparel side.
Yeah. On the fabric side, we are still operating on the autumn, winter, and the spring, summer as a model. But as we are moving into, we have started introducing flash collections depending on the requirement of the market and the trends that we are seeing as changing. So that is the way we trend to fill in the gaps on the fabric side. For apparel, I will request Pokarnaji to respond.
Thank you. For apparel, from 2 season, we moved on to the 4 season. So we have separated autumn and winter. Then we have separated spring and summer. So we are approaching customer on an average every quarter with a new collection. And that is also helping us in optimizing the inventory and also helping customer to optimize the inventory. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Govind Lal Gilada as an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening to Raymond team. Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah. So, I want to understand broader big picture of Raymond. I am shareholder since last 3 years. So, Sindhania sir, our chairman sir, always is more emphasis on shareholder's value creation, and he has walked the talk. He is seeing value and he has bought it all levels, stock from market and preferential allotment in last 3 years at various prices. He bought it 1,000 also, 675 also. Recently, a month, 2 months back, he has bought it 350 also. So promoter is seeing value, and there is value. Raymond is a household brand. There is FMCG. Stake is there. Real estate is there. So I want to understand, sir, in spite of all that, the story is known to everybody, because in the last 3 months, Raymond team has taken a lot of effort, conducted a lot of meets, met institutional investors, HNIs, one-to-one, number of times. So where we are failing in our job to give conviction to market, now all indices are at new high. Raymond touched 1,100 2 years back or 1.5 years back, and it is now quoting at 440 after even that time, even real estate was not unlocked. This 20 acres was not sold even. So the merger was not announced. Not much with key positive things happening. That was 1,100. After that, we are developing land. We have sold land. The merger we have announced. So I want to understand, sir, what is and other all our textile peer shares, they are almost at their high. So where market is not believing that story, that's a bigger picture I want to understand, sir.
Okay. So look, fundamentally, if you see that Raymond as a brand is not a brand, younger brand. It is a very strong brand recall, and practically you would have recall in the entire country with all the Indians, as we have completed more than 96 years. So therefore, from a brand recall point of view, we are absolutely, in terms of the product quality, we are absolutely on the top end. As far as the network is concerned, we are on the top end. So what is happening, we have achieve these successes. Obviously, the COVID impacts this business, because when you don't have the brick and mortar store open, you will not be able to go and shop. However, if you look at it, that the effort which the company need to put in have gone and put substantial amount of effort. If I look at it in terms of the OPEX cost reduction, there has been a substantial reduction in the OPEX cost, which when the sales gets restored, a significant portion, as we have alluded in number of times, that a certain cost savings will be permanent in nature and which will improve the bottom line. As far as the other unlocking is concerned in terms of value unlocking, we said we are monetizing the Thane land. We sold, as you rightly pointed out, we have sold our 20 acre of land. We are constructing this real estate 3 million square feet project. And as I also mentioned on the other question, that we also intend to do, when we get the right price and right opportunity in terms of selling additional pieces of land, as well as constructing multiple use of product. For example, be it a commercial, be it residential, be it any other alternate use. So we are very clear that we want to unlock the value. Third thing, if you see, the third key component is also the deleveraging. If you see, over the last seven quarters, the company has philosophically reduced the debt almost by 1,000 crores till March, and maybe there is a small increase in the debt right now, which is more temporary in nature because of the increase in the working capital, which I explained in my opening remarks. So, as well as the demerger has been announced. So, I think we have done all the right things which is required for a true value unlock, and we are on the path of that value unlock. Once many of these things get accomplished and the results are seen, some results have been already seen, some will be seen in the near future, which will enable the unlock in the value.
Hello?
Hello, yes.
Yeah. Thanks for your elaborate answer to my question. Here again, sir, I got, COVID is affected to your other peers also. It is not that it is affected to Raymond only. And the stock market is forward looking. So what you are telling, unlocking everything, market, why value they are not giving to the stock? That is my, what you are talking, everything market knows, sir, what you are going to do and what you are doing right now. The thing is that other companies, the people are believing valuation they are giving to other companies in textile sector. Why Raymond is not recognized true potential of its intrinsic worth? That is my question.
No, so as I said, we are on that path, we are on the journey where we are doing the right thing, and the market is going to recognize that. It is not that the markets are far more mature. They will recognize that clearly. And we are doing the right things in order to ensure that we create the shareholder value. And you look at the various steps, deleveraging, the return on invested capital. If you see that the kind of returns which we are going to get on the demerged business of the lifestyle is going to be phenomenally higher. So this all translates that all the right things which you need to do, there is some things which are a work in progress. Once the work in progress gets completed, you will be able to see the result as well.
So great, sir. I wish you all the best. And last one question, is there any thought on FMCG unlocking value, selling our stake, anything in that direction board is thinking?
So look, FMCG is a very important part of the business, and we have seen that it is very encouraging, the results which we have seen. We have got a very high quality management, and we expect that, considering that the product which we have both in the deos and the sexual wellness space is top of the notch, in that sense we are getting a high market share, and it is a build case. As I see that the next 3 years is a build phase for our FMCG business, and when we are building this FMCG business, then we will be able to see a significantly higher value with improved margins.
Thank you. Mr. Gulada, requested to join the queue for any follow-up. Also, participants are requested to limit their question to two per participant. The next question is from the line of Umang Shah from Edelweiss. Please go ahead.
Hi sir, good evening. I again the same question that I would be wondering on. So the demerger process is still stuck from our end. We have still not went to NCLT. That is that factually right, or is there some misunderstanding from my end?
No, so NCLT is done. Now the other processes, other some of the authority regulatory clearances which we are supposed to get, and as I explained in my opening script, that we will complete the demerger of this in this fiscal year.
Okay. All right, sir. So secondly, from overall the call impression that we are getting is that the complete man, Raymond, the complete man, the whole brand is, you know, we are not expanding or we are not trying to advertise the way we were doing it. Obviously, for various reasons, that it's a lockdown, people cannot go and buy. So advertising is obviously something that we won't be looking at. But when we were trying to create our online presence, we started with our online ad spends and we were increasing that. Now, where are we standing on it? So we were looking to create our own website and function it, which is for actually working very well, to be very honest. There are various products, even fabric combos, home textiles, everything is available over there. But now going forward, what is our online direction? Because suddenly it seems that we would be now more focusing more on e-commerce versus our own proprietary kind of website. And secondly, whenever now we would be again, you know, focusing on retail. So what is the clear line of thought for selling Raymond, the complete man brand? Apart from Raymond Realty, I would like to focus on Raymond also, textiles also, that's right.
You know, absolutely. Raymond is a main lifestyle business. So it's a lifestyle brand. And if you see the advertisement, the sales promotion, I don't know, did you watch the early, what you call IPL matches? We brought our advertisement, but when in April, we got hit by the COVID, that pushed us back, and there was no point of continuing with the advertisement because there was a lockdown. In terms of all the digital experiences we have got, we are present in all the major marketplaces. We are present on our own myraymond.com. And in order to elaborate more, I will ask Ganesh to talk on the online and the digital, the way we are moving forward.
Right. Thank you so much, Amit. You're absolutely right. We had started off with the online spends. We had started off with the advertisement, as Amit said, in the month of April. And as the second wave slipped in, we also pulled back on some of the expenses because at the end of the day, it has to reach to the consumer where it matters. But having said that, as we are looking forward into the coming into the next season, we will be getting back into using our digital media and the other spends. Today, as we speak, we have on the digital media communications on a garment exchange program which is being run across all our stores. And we continue to work on, we are the style partner for the Olympic squad, so there is a communication which is going on that bit also. Now, coming back to our own website, myraymond.com, the end destination for this website is basically to be a house of fashion for Raymond, where consumers around the marketplace, around the, can reach there and look at what are the men's fashion trends that Raymond is bringing onto the market. And then there is also an option of a transaction that can take place, but the primary focus is to give consumer a great experience and visibility on how we drive this fashion. Okay, I hope that gives one answer. Second is on the digitization. We are ourselves as an organization moving into a full journey on digitization in terms of how we collect consumer data, how you analyze data and drive database decision making. There is a full-fledged plan that is being worked out and being implemented as we speak.
Okay, so, but sir, if I'm not wrong, when we already had a good amount of data from our loyalty customers, I mean, the reach that we had with that program or the data that we had, that was one big, I would say, asset that the company had.
Right.
So are we still utilizing that to reach out to our customers, or this is a new data set that we are now working on?
Of course, we are using our existing database, which is a very strong property of the brand, which has been collected over years.
Right, sir.
Our communication is now targeted using those data, so that we are doing very targeted communication rather than a shotgun approach.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is in the line of Rishikesh Oza from RoboCapital. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hi, sir. So my question is related to this 2800 crore revenue and 800 crore PAT that we are expecting in real estate in the next 3 to 4 years. So here we are talking about a cumulative figure. Am I correct?
Yes, it is the revenue for the entire 3 million square feet and the profitability for the 3 million square feet project.
Okay, but it's a cumulative figure or 3-4 years, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and most of it likely going to be reported or recognized in later part of the year, maybe third or fourth?
No, actually, if you see, it will be spread. You know, the real estate project with 3,000 plus units doesn't sell only 1 year. It sold over a 3-4 year period. And you see the demonstrated performance of the company. If we have sold 60% of the launched inventory, as I mentioned, that we have already sold the 60% of the launched inventory, we see very clearly that the profitability will be distributed over the entire 4 year period. So we have sold already 1448 and the construction is at a phenomenal pace. So you will see the distribution of this profit over the next 3 years, more or less equally.
Okay, that will do. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Our next question is on the line of Dixit Doshi from Whitestone Financial Advisors. Please go ahead.
Hello. Sir, I'm Dixit Doshi.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I would like to know in Raymond Realty at this point of time, what is the booking rate, average booking rate, which we are selling at and on per square foot basis?
We have got Harmon, the new CEO for the reality business.
Yeah.
Harmon?
Yeah. One crore per unit that we are charging. On the carpet area, the current rate will be around 20,000, slightly upward of 20,000 rupees per square foot.
20,000 rupees per square foot, right?
Of carpet area, that's right.
Okay. And my second question was, what would be the tentative construction cost? Because you see, just to have some guesstimate about the future profitability, if you could share some benchmark construction cost.
So, as I mentioned,
1,500 to 4,000 rupees?
No, as I mentioned, we are not disclosing the construction cost because we have certain unique construction cost methodology and we have put in a lot of efficiency. Therefore, we are not disclosing this construction cost. We have given the guidance that the project is going to deliver over 900 crores of cash flows and profitability in this business.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to our participants, if you wish to ask a question, please press star and one. Ladies and gentlemen, that would be our last question for today. I now hand the conference over to the management for their closing comments. Thank you and over to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for participating in this call and having interest in Raymond Limited. Now we will talk to you once again in the next quarter. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Antique Stock Broking, that concludes this conference. Thank you all for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.